Have you ever noticed how your keyboard develops shiny spots on the keys you use the most often? Yeah, mine does, and often I find that I'm spending a lot of time on my space bar. My space bar has kind of a couple of shiny spots where each thumb seems to attack it. Now, these shiny spots that I'm seeing are actually changes in surface texture compared to the other keys. And in these zones, I have a surface that is kind of a top surface with some pits and valleys and things underneath it, whereas the other keys that have less abuse are made up of peaks and valleys surrounding this running surface. Now, this is common in many applications. Many of our surfaces in the real world have a core surface that's going to carry a load, and then peaks and valleys above and below that running surface that may matter to us for surface control and functionality. This surface, we'll put another valley over here perhaps, is common in engines and hydraulics and aerospace and many other cases where a surface is in contact with another surface. Now, we can't describe this kind of surface with a single number. There are three things that we care about. There are the peaks for the break-in, the core that carries the load, and the valleys that might carry lubrication. A single number can't describe that, so we're going to look to a family of numbers to describe this, and particularly we're going to talk about the RK family of parameters. Not a single number, but a few numbers to describe the discrete characteristics. Now, these numbers come from the material ratio curve. If you're not familiar with the material ratio curve, press pause here and slide over to our video on material ratio, where you'll see where this particular curve comes from, and it's a representation of how much material we have at various depths as we slice our way down the surface. At the top, we don't have any material, 0%, and as we slice our way down, we work our way out to 100% material. In the world of the material ratio curve, in this space, we find that a horizontal zone relates to a smooth region over here, and that's exactly what the running surface is. Somewhere in here is a very horizontal region, and that relates to a smooth region over here, and we're going to use this thinking. We're going to fit a line through all of those red points in this curve right through there and extend it out to 100% and extend it back to 0%. And when we do this, we have established what we call the RK line. This line starts up here and ends down here, and it gives us a height. This height right here is the middle of our sandwich. This height is the RK value itself. It is the RK number. It describes the peak to valley of our running surface. And this thing right here, this height, RK, is a very useful and stable parameter for lots of applications. Now, let's look below this, because that's an interesting area for many industries, is this oil holding volume of these valleys. That volume is actually made up of this red zone out here on the curve. You can kind of see a curl with an area that kind of diminishes beyond the curve. We can use that area and this upper boundary of it and use that information to come up with a parameter for an effective valley depth. If I make a black triangle here of the same exact area as the red zone, the depth of this black triangle is kind of an effective valley depth. It's not an actual depth of any one of these valleys, but it's kind of the effective valley depth of all these valleys combined. It would kind of give us a valley of somewhere around here being our typical or effective oil holding depth. So we have now broken our surface into the running surface, RK, and here is the RVK part of the surface. And similarly, we're going to generate a triangle up here in the peak world and have a height up here of the effective peak height. And this is RPK. So our surface sandwich of a core running surface with peaks and valleys can be described by this RK parameter family. Now there are some more numbers relative to the material ratios where these transitions occur. There's more information on how we derive this line and these parameters. Not enough time here, but check out digitalmetrology.com. Let us know if you have questions and we'll be happy to help.